Let's bring in Tom DeMark, CEO of Market Studies and creator of the DeMark Indicators. We're bringing him on because if you listened to him call for a top in tech stocks back in September, he would have saved you from a 6% drop. Good to have you on the show. We're all excited. Tell me first, how do you make these calls? Is it overly simplistic to call you a technician?
No, I'd rather the description be more a market timer. We've used mathematical models to arrive at totally definitive, objective impressions as to far as to how the market is behaving at prospective market tops and bottoms. We try to anticipate the tops and bottoms before they occur, so we're really exhaustion. We use these models to identify trend exhaustion.
Okay, trend exhaustion. I think if people understand that intuitively, the trend at some point runs out of steam. What are you calling for right now?
Well, what we're looking for right now is really, it's past tense. At the April high, the NASDAQ, for example, NASDAQ 100 topped, as did the S&P average, into the June low. And both of them, both indices worked concurrently and both produced what we call 13s, which identify exhaustion when the last seller is sold, figuratively speaking. We try to anticipate the bottoms rather than buy after the low, as it's very difficult to buy after a trend has already begun.
So it looks like you're expecting, we're in the middle of a pullback that you are saying yes. You predicted. So how much more do we get of this pullback?
Well, see what we did. On September 14th, the NASDAQ 100 produced a 13, which was the exhaustion of the trend to the upside. And then the following week, on September 21st, the NASDAQ Composite followed suit. The S&P really didn't work in, the S&P futures really didn't concur until October 5th. What's happening now, we've got a lag in the S&P cash. And this is somewhat akin to what happened throughout the period August of last year, August into September into October. The number of major indices produced bottoms, one in particular, August 9th, and then subsequent bottoms. But the S&P cash lagged and didn't make its low until October 3rd, October 4th. So what we're looking at right now is the prospect of a possible one more move upside in the S&P cash, which is the SPX, all the way up to 1478.03 to 1485.33. And at that time, which should occur within the next 10 to 12 trading days, that the market should top out, that market, and the other indices such as the Russell and small cap and technology indices that have already made their tops should recover anywhere from 40 to 60% of the recent declines. And they will not confirm that peak, that rally.
Okay.
That
we foresee. Tim Seymour is dying to get in here.
Hey, Tom, it's Tim. You know, first of all, you know, Tom has been one of the little secrets on Wall Street that guys have been following for a long time. And I would characterize Tom as being a little different in that he's less subjective than technical guys, and I think you would call him a mathematician. So what I love about what you do is because what we try to be, it's somewhat contrarian. Great call on China, I think, about 6 weeks ago, nailing a bottom. Where else can we look at places that are so hated that, again, you're starting to see your indicators with counts, as you call them, that are starting to say these are 8, 9 buys? You know, and some of the bigger trades out there that people are looking at and that are hated, where are you contrarian here?
There really isn't much in the equity side of the market that looks positive at the current time. We're in the midst of a decline, and I don't see this decline abating for some time. I think we probably made the highs for the year, definitely, in a number of these indices, and the only one that has some redemption left would be the S&P cash. And obviously you get sympathy with the S&P futures and some of the derivatives, but even the ETFs and ETNs all topped as well. So this is a singular call. It's a pretty much a solo move that we're expecting, and it's really a bold call because last year, after the August 9th low, the August 8th closing low, when the market experienced a rally from around 1101 in the S&P cash all the way up to 1239. No one expected that low on August 8th and 9th to be undercut, but we were looking for 1076. And as it turned out, the market made a low of 1075 in fraction before it rallied. And like I said, if you use one of the charts we provided was the inversion of the August, September low. And if you look at it, we're on the same cycle right now. We've had a rally since the into the August 8th low last year from the early May, late April peak was 114 days.
Now, Tom, what would you have to hear or see right now to change your mind? In other words, what would have to happen in the market here for you to turn from this very bearish outlook that you have, in particular starting in the tech? But if what would you have to see, sir?
I don't think we cannot turn positive on the market. Like I said, we're right now only holding to the S&P cash as a rally. The overall trend of the market is definitely down, and we're going to see a very long extended decline. We've made the highs for the year. But like with the environment we're in, which is pretty much the reverse of what we experienced last August, September, we can see this spike up. I don't know if it's going to be something, a catalyst such as the debate, possibly the election, but you'll see a sharp move upside according to our work. And like I said, it's really we're operating against the trend, which we don't like to do.
All
right. We do see new.
Tom, thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate it. We got a little bit of a satellite delay, I think, so we're getting cut off. But it was great to have you on. Great insight. We're going to discuss a little bit more behind your back after you go, okay? Thanks, Tom.
Okay, thank you very much.
What do you guys think?
Well, I think, first of all, again, some of the smartest hedge funds in the world have been doing this for a long time. What people get worried about with DeMark is now that everybody's following this guy, are these trends not as powerful? And, in fact, it's probably the opposite. You are selling strength. You are buying weakness. This is why it's very interesting. It's pretty scary to hear him call a top in for the year. And what he said is that, basically, it tells you where people are positioned. People are positioned for a year-end rally, and clearly these guys aren't there.